Hi, this is Nacedo 375. I'm coming to you from Kitchen Creek. I'm out here camping and hunting. Oh, the emphasis is on camping. And it's November 19th, 2011. I wanted to say welcome to my kitchen. This is the way I do it. I'm in a Coleman Sunrise Point, 12-foot by 12-foot, 8-person tent. So I have a lot of room, although I have used this same setup in an 8-foot by 8-foot tent. And, of course, the 8-foot by 8-foot, that's the footprint or the dimensions at the base. Dome tents, as you know, slope inward, and you lose a lot of space that way. But in a 12-foot by 12-foot tent, this setup is a joy to use. I've got a standard Coleman cooler here. I fill it, I don't fill it, but I put 4 inches of water in the bottom, and I put it in my upright freezer in the garage, and I freeze it for about 3 days to make sure it's solid all the way through, and I don't have a bunch of water in there. Under the frozen ice, and fill it with whatever I want, and that's up to you, whatever you put in here. It's your personal taste. Then I use a Coleman propane stove, standard propane cylinders at Walmart, 2 for about $5. I think this stove was $25. It's got a nice, wide top with some serrations on the supports here for your pan, so I've never spilled anything off of here. And I can't say the same for those little, what do they call them, pocket rocket stoves? My buddy had one of those, and I tried using it, and I ended up dumping my grits in the dirt. But anyway, be that as it may, you got something to cook with here. You got your cooler to keep your stuff fresh in the summer. In the winter, it helps a little bit, but, you know, it's pretty cold. Stuff keeps pretty well. The real secret, though, especially in a smaller tent or even this tent, is this blue bag. And what does this blue bag have in it? Well, I'm going to show you. You probably figured that out already. I've got 3 bags inside this. They're just standard grocery bags. On top, generally on top, not this time. One bag has my spices in it, 6 different spices, plastic bags, matches. Another bag getting kind of ratty. When these get worn out, I replace them. The other bag has snacks. This is the one I try to keep on top. There's my coffee and creamer and Splenda. And I got some chocolate bars. I got bouillon cubes, chicken and beef. And I even got some something a little more esoteric. What do we got here? Wild herring filet and Cabernet sauce, Cabernet wine sauce. And where did these come from? Oh, Canada. I've had some sardines and stuff and olive oil from Canada. And Canada, they know what they're doing. Also Scotland, the bristling sardines and that. But I have stuff like that in there, as well as the candy bars. And sometimes I'll put granola bars. And I've got grits in here and some other good stuff. Whatever you want, that's the thing. The key is I had to divide everything up into 3 bags because everything was together in here. And you try to organize it. But it was all together, and after you go through it, looking for stuff 2 or 3 times, everything's on top of each other and all intermingled. In my last bag, utensils. Don't have to explain this. Forks. I've even got scissors in. I've got a flashlight. Got all kinds of stuff in here. 2 different kinds of can openers, potato peeler. That's my utensils. So that's it. That's the secret. It keeps everything separate. And when I'm cooking, depending on what I'm doing, or if it's in the dark. I mean, if it's in the day, sometimes I'll take out all 3 bags and just line them up side by side. And then I can take out whatever I need. I've got everything all organized. At least it seems organized to me. So let's make something. Pretend like it's late at night. It's dark. You can't see a thing. So I turn on a little flashlight, or I turn on my little lantern that puts out 7 lumens that I got at Walmart. I go to Walmart a lot. And now we got to put everything back in the bag for the demo. I could have paused it and strung them together. But usually I try to set my snack bag on top, because that's got my coffee, my hot chocolate, all that tea, all that good stuff in it. Let's see if I got this. Got this pretty well. So I go in here and I open her up. And Here's my coffee, creamer, and my Splenda. I use the Great Value. It's not really Splenda. I use the Great Value brand. And I like the Buendia. Juan Valdez. Yeah, I like the guy with the little donkey or whatever. Good coffee. So, I take that out. Put the blue bag aside. Grab my handy-dandy Ozark Trail wind-resistant lighter. And I turn on my stove. Let's bring this over here. So she's lit. Then, here's another secret I have. I have these basins. I got a bunch of these. Actually, these, well, I won't tell you where they came from. They're not stolen. Like to work over a basin in case I don't want to spill liquids, water, milk, coffee, whatever. And I don't want crumbs on the floor. So I get my stuff out. And if it's late at night, I just leave this stuff sit here. I won't put it away. I'll put it away the next morning when it's daylight. Buendia, Juan Valdez. The guy with the donkey knows best. So this thing here, and this is Great Value brand, and Alaskan salmon came in this. And I can't really say the salmon was that great, but maybe I didn't prepare it right. I think I put it in a soup or something, and it wasn't that great. But this is the greatest drinking cup. I put my little rubber band thing there for when it's hot. This holds about a cup and a half. So I'm going to take a heaping, and notice I'm not doing it over the thing like I said. I think I need just a hair more. We'll put that lid back on. By the time I get this the coffee in there, what do you want to bet the water's hot? Okay, this is a hazelnut creamer. Of course, it's not in the original jar. This is an empty bouillon cube. I use the Herbox, no MSG bouillon cubes. They are numero uno, number one, and I like a lot. Now again, if it's late at night, I'm not going to put this stuff away. I'll just leave it sitting there. And maybe somebody's going to say, well, what if you want something else? And I say, well, if I want something else, I'll get it out, and I'll probably leave that set out too. I guess I'm not in the picture here. Okay, here, I'm just going to throw those in there. It's good for catching everything. You notice the water's steaming? So I'm going to turn it off. It's already hot. It's boiling. Okay, I'm going to pour this over. Now, the best way of doing this is to pour it, put the damn cup down, because this is hot. Pardon my French there. Now, that's pretty full. I must have pre-measured that. Again, I'm still over the plastic basin. And there we go. It's late at night. I got maybe I got Art Bell or George Norrie and Coast to Coast AM on the radio. And I'm listening to the weirdness. And I'm all set. And that's it. Anyway, thanks for watching. Appreciate your views. And hope you got some ideas from how to maybe set up a kind of a makeshift kitchen when you're out car camping. Talk to you later.